Hi, welcome to YSHIS. This is Ramya Ravindran and we'll be continuing with our polity series. Okay, this chapter 3, this was done long back, Salient Features of Constitution. It was done. Only two tables are pending. Okay, that was supposed to be done with the chapter itself, but since the chapter was very long, I did not take it that time, but we'll cover it now. Okay, so those two tables we'll be doing right now. Yeah, we all know that Kerala flood, it was one of the biggest disaster that it has witnessed in its history. Okay, Kerala has lost a lot of lives, many infrastructure has been lost, houses, buildings, roads, bridges, everything has been collapsed. But the thing that needs to be commended is that everybody, okay, every Keralaite or every citizen of that state has literally come out on road and they have helped each other. Okay, these boards that you see, these are not provided by any government. Whether they did not wait for anybody, if they did not wait for any state government or any central government or any official, any disaster official to come and help them, they have helped each other. Okay, all of them have come out on the road. Everything was lost. Okay, these fishermen, everything was their home, their property, everything was gone. The only thing that was left with them was these boats. Okay, and they have given up all those things so that it can be used by all the people. Okay, so that is the mentality of those people. They have like done a very commendable job, very brave act. Okay, see all these movie stars, they have literally stayed in the camps, okay, with the common people. They have stayed for days all together, helping each other, coming live and asking for help and coordinating with each other. So all those things have been done, everything is done, and but still right even now 3 lakh people, over 3 lakh people are staying in camps. Okay, they need medical help, they need a lot of things for of daily use, they need money so that their lives can be rebuilt. Everything that is gone can be rebuilt, nothing has happened. The lives that is gone, yeah, that is a loss, obviously that is a loss, but apart from that nothing has been lost. Anything that has been shattered by this disaster can be rebuilt. Okay, life will get back on track, slowly but steadily it will happen. And I urge everyone to do whatever is possible from your side. Help is been arriving at Kerala from all corners of the world. Okay, everywhere, wherever you go, you will find a Keralite residing in any corner of this world. Okay, so help is arriving from everywhere, and generous help has been provided. Okay, so do whatever is possible. If you cannot make any monetary donation, even that is fine. At least pray for Kerala. Okay. So that was regarding Kerala and the flood. Yeah, in the previous lecture I have told you not many answer sheets have been submitted, but many people have submitted. Okay, so like first initial two tests, even this test, lot of good answers have been given by the students. Okay, so we see that people are like students are putting lot of hard work in writing answers. Okay, so keep up the good work. Okay, yeah, I have not shown these two things since quite some time. So these are the static syllabus of our prelims test series. You'll be getting 45 tests. Okay, so every month on 4th you will be getting the delivery. Okay, so 45 tests in one slot you won't be getting. It will come in packages. Okay, so by December you will get everything. This is the static portion. And then this is the dynamic portion, that is pure current affairs. Okay, so from June till next May. Okay, so that is the coverage. Okay, so everything put together you will be getting around 20 tests, and here in the static portion you will be getting 150 revision charts also. Okay, so I yeah, this is one question sample. Okay, I really love this, so I have kept it. Yeah, there is this golden combo offer that is going on. You will save some money if you buy in a combo package. Okay, prelims plus mains. Okay, so this is open till end of August. Okay, so you can buy before that and save some money. Yeah, now these two tables, okay, one is schedules and another one is the sources, okay. I told you we have taken everything from the constitution of other countries, okay. We have adapted it, but it has been influenced by various constitutions of other countries. So that list we will see and this list we will see. So how many schedules do we have? We have 12 schedules. Originally, we had only 8 schedules, but 4 were added later on, okay. So now, as of now, we have 12 schedules, okay. So we will very quickly see what are those. First schedule, name of the states or union territory and their extent. Extent in the sense geographical extent. Okay. So first schedule, name of state and extent. Second, salary and privileges. Okay. Whose salary? President and governor. Okay. These two positions, the head of state at the central level and at the state level. Then Speaker and Deputy Speaker of Lok Sabha and Speaker and Deputy Speaker at Legislative Assembly. Okay. Then Chairman and Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha, that is at the central level, then at the this Legislative Council. Okay. So four personalities are mentioned here. Okay. Next, judges of Supreme Court and High Court. Okay. After that, Comptroller and Auditor General. This is a unique thing, so do not miss this. Comptroller and Auditor General. This can be asked. Okay, this is a potential question. So, whenever you see such tables, you are supposed to note what has been mentioned, and more important is the thing that you should note what is not mentioned. Okay, so what is not mentioned here? Vice President is not mentioned, and Prime Minister is not there. Okay, Prime Minister and Vice President, these are not included in the second schedule. Okay. Otherwise, President, Governor, Speaker, Deputy Speaker, Chairman, Deputy Chairman at the Lok Sabha level, at the Legislative Assembly level, at the Rajya Sabha and at the Legislative Council. Then judges of both the courts, Supreme and High Court. Third schedule, we have oaths and affirmation. Okay. Why two names? See, oaths and affirmation, we have two different names because whenever you are joining the office, either you can take oath or affirmation in the name of God, or if you are a believer, or if you are not a believer, you can exclude that part. Okay, so that is the reason we have two set of things. One is oath, another one affirmation. Okay, it depends whether you are a believer or you are an atheist or a non-believer. Okay, what are the oaths and affirmation? Whose oaths and affirmations are included in the schedule? Union Minister and State Minister. Okay. See, the ones that are mentioned in the schedule, that is there, okay. And the other offices which are not mentioned in the schedule, that will be mentioned in the constitution, the text of the constitution, okay. Or in some other law, okay. So, this is schedule. In schedule, whose oaths and affirmations are there? Union Minister and State Minister. So, this minister will include Prime Minister and Chief Minister also, okay. So, do not confuse. Ministers will include Chief Minister and Prime Minister. Then candidate for election to the Parliament and to the state legislature. Okay, so at both the level, it is not necessary that he should win the election. Okay, even if you're standing for the election, then you're supposed to take the oath and affirmation, and that oath and affirmation is mentioned in the schedule, third schedule. After that, members of Parliament and state legislature. Okay, minister and member of parliament, this is different. Okay, ministers are a subset of member of parliament. Okay, then judges of Supreme Court and High Court, comptroller and auditor general. Okay, so these two are common in the second schedule and in the third schedule. Okay, fourth schedule, allocation of seats in Rajya Sabha to the states and the union territories. Okay, see, in Rajya Sabha, the seats are reserved. Okay, so and every state or every union territory, it is bifurcated. Okay, so a larger state will have more number of seats allocated to it, and states of Northeast will have one seat, probably one or two seats allocated in Rajya Sabha. Okay, so that number is mentioned in the fourth schedule. Then in the fifth schedule, what do we have? Administration of scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. Okay. So, 5th and 6th, do not miss this. This have been asked many times. 5th and 6th, it is exclusively for scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. But 6th one is specifically for these four states. Okay. AM, TM. Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram. Okay, which MS absent here? Manipur is not there. Okay, so I have told you always look for the thing that is not there. Okay, so Manipur is not there, other two M's are there, Meghalaya, Mizoram, and A and T obviously you will know. Okay, then seventh one, division of power between union and the state, that is union list, state list and concurrent list. Which subjects are mentioned in which list? That is given in seventh schedule. Okay, eighth schedule, it is the languages which are recognized by the constitution. How many do we have? 22. Okay, so we will first see what are there. Assamese, it is in the alphabetical order. Okay, Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, Dogri, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Maithili, Malayalam, Manipuri, Marathi, Nepali, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Santali, Sindhi, Tamil, Telugu, Urdu. Okay, so what is the thing that you should note here? English is not there. Okay, English is not there and Rajasthani is not there. Those two languages are missing. Okay, apart from that, every language of every state is there. Okay, and what are the unique things or the languages which are not very common? Bodo, Dogri, Konkani, Maithili, Santali. Okay, these five languages you remember because they can give you some other languages and you will feel that I have seen it somewhere. Okay, but Dogri, Bodo, Konkani, Maithili, Santali, only five languages. All other languages are languages of states. Okay, and another thing that you should notice, we have Kashmiri and we have Urdu as well. Okay, two languages for Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, so both are there in the constitution. Another thing that you should notice, Sanskrit is there. Okay, Sanskrit is mentioned. Apart from that, we know all the states have different languages and all are mentioned in the constitution. Ninth one, see, ninth one, what do we have? These are acts and regulations. Okay, these are given by state and some are given by the parliament as well. Okay, so what is the speciality of ninth schedule? If you place any law in this ninth schedule, that cannot be challenged in the judiciary. Okay, so judicial review is not applicable to it. So what was the thing that was placed here? It was with respect to land reform. This was one of the most debatable topic. Okay, the first amendment itself happened because of this. Okay, so land reform and abolition of zamindari system. Okay, so all the laws that have been framed by different state governments, that is placed here. Okay, and then for parliament also have framed various laws, but those are for different matters. Okay, so those laws have also been placed in the ninth schedule. But what has Supreme Court said? Supreme Court has given this judgment in 2007. Okay, 2007 Supreme Court said that such a blanket safeguard cannot be done. Okay, that is not possible, that is not applicable. Okay, so any law which is made after April 24, 1973, remember this date, April 24, 1973, any law placed under this section after this date is open for judicial review. Now, why this special date? What is the importance? This is the day when the Keshav Nanda Bharti case gave its verdict. Okay, so what is the importance of that case? We will look at some other time. As of now, just know that it is because of Keshav Nanda Bharti judgment date that we have selected this date. Okay, 10th one, it is anti-defection law. Okay, anti-defection law, when ministers move from one party to another party, they can be defected. Okay, so that is anti-defection. Now, I have told you, till 8, it was present in the original constitution as well. Okay, after that, these things have been added later. Okay, so 9th one, this was added by the, I told you, very first amendment act. This is 1951. Okay, then 10th one, this was added by 52nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1985. Okay, so these are all important, 52nd Constitutional Amendment Act 1985. Then all of us know that 11th and 12th, these were added for panchayats and municipalities, 73rd, 74th and year, same year, 1992. Okay, so that was regarding schedules. Very quickly we'll see. Okay, first one, name and extent. Second, salary and privileges. Third, oath or affirmation. Fourth, allocation of seat in Rajya Sabha. Fifth and sixth, regarding scheduled area and scheduled tribe. Sixth is specifically for AMTM. Manipur is not there. Seventh one, three list. Eighth one, 22 languages. Ninth one, protection from judicial review. Okay, and this date has to be remembered. 10th one, anti-defection law. 11th and 12th, panchayat and municipalities respectively. Now, these are the sources of constitution. Okay, we have borrowed various features from various constitutions. Okay, so I have told you, Government of India Act 1935. This is one thing that has influenced us a lot. Okay, so what is it that is taken from here? First one, federal scheme. What is federal scheme? That is power being divided between both the systems, that is central government and the state government. So that arrangement has been taken from 1935 Government of India Act. Okay, so federal scheme. Then office of governor. Okay, so office of governor from 1935. Another one, judiciary. Okay, I'm not talking about specific aspects of judiciary, but judiciary as a whole has been taken from 1935 Act. Okay, after that, PSC. This is Public Service Commission. I've told you, Public Service Commission existed even before independence. We have seen that. Okay, while covering the acts, we have seen that. Okay, Public Service Commission was introduced. Then emergency provisions. Okay, even this is provided by 1935. After that, the administrative details, the small integrity, okay, all those things have been taken from 1935. So, office of governor, federal scheme, judiciary as a whole, okay, we are not talking about any specific aspect of judiciary, but judiciary as a whole. Then from British constitution, see, everything that is related to parliament has been taken from British, okay. So, what is it? Parliamentary government. Rule of law. Rule of law, we know. Earlier, we all had different laws for different caste and different religion, okay. So, when these Britishers arrived, they came up with this judiciary system, okay. They framed the laws. So, we all know, rule of law, it is taken from British constitution. They have introduced it to us. Then, legislative procedure, that is law making. Obviously, since they have introduced a system of law, the procedure is taken from their constitution. Then single citizenship. USA has double citizenship, but British has single citizenship, and we have taken it from them. Then cabinet system. I've told you, cabinet system, this is a subset of ministers. Okay, few ministers will be there in the cabinet system. Prerogative writ. Prerogative writ, why is it used? We have seen it somewhere. Okay, I have not explained it. I will explain it some other time. But whenever your fundamental right is being violated, you can directly go to the Supreme Court. And Supreme Court will issue these writs, okay. Even High Court can issue, but in case of fundamental rights, people can directly go to Supreme Court, okay. So, that is the concept of writ. Then, parliamentary privileges, that is, what is the privileges that members have as individuals and collective privileges. So, all those put together was taken from British Constitution. Then, bicameralism, that is, two houses, okay. So, if you look at it, overall, all these things are related to this parliamentary system. Okay. From USA, what have we taken? Obviously, fundamental right is the most important thing that has been taken from USA. Okay. USA is known for fundamental rights and the judiciary system. Okay. So, that those two things have been taken from USA. One is fundamental right. Second one, independence of judiciary, judicial review. Then removal of Supreme Court and High Court judges. Then these two things. Okay. See, the post of Vice President and impeachment of President. Okay. See, President appointment is not there, but impeachment of President is there. Okay. Do not get confused. Whenever the question is just about judiciary, you should write Government of India Act 1935. But if it is about independence of judiciary, judicial review, removal of judges, all these things, USA. Okay, then Irish, what have we taken? We know DPSP is from Irish. This is a very important point. It has been asked several times. Okay, DPSP from Irish. Then nomination of members to Rajya Sabha. We know Rajya Sabha has got elected members as well as nominated members. Okay, so this nomination of members, this concept has been taken from Irish. Do not forget this. Okay, then another thing, method of election to president. Okay, that is taken from Irish. Method of election to president, Irish. And removal is taken from USA. Okay, so do not forget this. USA and Irish both have this president. Okay, one is impeachment, another one election. Then from Canada, see, Canada is known for a strong center. Okay, strong center. So what is it? Federation with a strong center, residuary power with the center. That is, what are residuary powers? See, we have three lists. One is state list, central list and concurrent list. Okay, so whatever is known to us, whatever is existing as of now, we have bifurcated it into three systems. Okay, three list. But there might be things which doesn't exist as of now, but it will come up in the future. Okay, we don't know what are those things. So anything that comes up in the future and it is not listed as of now, all those things will fall under residuary power. Okay, so any such thing coming up in the future, it has been already allocated to the central government. Okay, so that system is taken from Canada. Okay, so residuary power given to center is been taken from Canada. I have told you it is known for a strong central system. So anything that is making the central government more powerful, it is taken from Canada. Then appointment of governor by the center. See, when the governor, state governor is appointed by the center, obviously his inclinations will be more towards the central government. Okay, so he is like the ears and the eyes of the central government. So that is again making the center more powerful. Then advisory jurisdiction of Supreme Court. Okay, see, whenever president is in doubt, whenever he needs advice, president can take advice from the Supreme Court. Okay, so there are different criteria and different things are there. Okay, there are certain things in which whenever president is asking for advice, Supreme Court has to give the advice. Okay, and there are certain other criteria where even if the president is asking for advice, Supreme Court can reject it. Okay, Supreme Court can deny and it can say that it doesn't want to advise on it. Okay, so all those things we will see later. Australia, with respect to Australia, any Australia involves all the things which will have two different set of entities. Okay, concurrent list, it is been taken care of by state as well as center. Then freedom of trade and commerce, it is between two states. Then joint sitting of two houses, okay, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha of parliament. Okay, so all those which involves two entities, it is taken from Australia. Okay, see, what I'm saying is not the hard and fast rule, but it is just for you to for your recollection. Okay, so that you can memorize it easily. Germany, suspension of fundamental rights during emergency. Obviously you should remember Hitler and his rule. Okay, so suspension of fundamental rights. USSR, this is Russia. Okay, Russia is known for fundamental duties. Okay, it is a socialist country. Obviously you all might be knowing what is a socialist country. They do not believe in capitalist system. Capitalism is whatever profit you are making, it is yours. And when a country is having a socialist government, it will make sure that everybody grows equally. Okay, so nobody will be able to concentrate wealth. Okay, so wealth will be shared between everyone and all things, all infrastructure, everything will be with the government. Okay, and government will share it with everyone equally. So for them, more than fundamental rights, fundamental duties play an important role. Okay, because they believe that their duty towards the state is more important. What they do for the country is more important than what they get from the state. Okay, so fundamental duties, we have taken it from USSR. Then ideal of justice. Okay, this we have mentioned in the preamble. How is justice mentioned? We have social justice, we have economic justice, and we have political justice. Okay, so all three are there. Even this was a UPSC question. I don't remember which one. This was a UPSC question. Okay, then from France, what have we taken? We have taken this concept of republic. What is republic? the head of the state will be elected. Okay, we have an elected president. Okay, in Britain, we have this monarch. They will occupy the crown. They will occupy the throne on the basis of hereditary system. Okay, we don't have it in India. We have here. We have elected head. Then ideals of liberty, equality, and fraternity. Okay, all of us have studied the French Revolution, and we know that all these three concepts have been taken from the French Revolution. Okay, so these are mentioned in the preamble. Then from South Africa, what have we taken? The procedure of amendment. Okay, amending the constitution, that is taken from South Africa. And what else? Election of members to Rajya Sabha. Okay, somewhere we have seen nomination also here. Irish. Okay, so Irish is nomination and South Africa it is election. So do not forget this. Irish and South Africa both are with respect to Rajya Sabha, but one is nominated members, another one elected member. Okay, from Japan, what have we taken? Procedure established by law. I've told you we have this procedure established by law, whereas USA follows due process of law. Okay, but this procedure established by law is just on paper. Officially, as of now, we are also following due process of law. Okay, so do not get confused. Somewhere we have seen this also. Okay, so whenever the question is rule of law, you should write British Constitution, and when it is procedure established by law, you should write Japanese Constitution. Okay, so that's all for today. I have already showed you the prelims thing. Okay, and mains, yes, obviously it is going on right now. Mini is also going on, and full test series is going on. You all can join it. I think in the last lecture I have discussed one question also. So this is the email ID. You can mail us at this email ID and join any of the paid courses. Okay, so for more details, we'll be uploading all the videos. Everything is uploaded. You can go and check those things if you need more clarifications, or you can email us. Okay, so that's all for today. I'll come up with my next lecture very soon. Thank you so much.